So how can you get hollow cheeks? Well, hollow cheeks is that area between the zygomatic bone and the mandible down here, typically a little higher, just below what you would call your cheekbone. Things you can do at home, mewing, makeup, fillers, RF microneedling, we're covering it all today. So why would you want a high cheek? Well, the cheek is associated with youth, with beauty, and with fertility. Let's talk youth. It's youth because we, as we age, the fat kind of descends. We get a little growth of the fat pads around the face. The mandibular ligament, the ligament that holds everything up here, relaxes. And we also get fat around the neck and the submentum area. Okay, so that's youth. Beauty, well, look at the supermodels of the world. They often have high cheeks. Now, they're not only selected for high cheeks, but it's one of the main factors. Look around. And it's not just women, it's men too. Mewing, you see that all over. I'm going to talk about mewing in a moment. But you hear that of people who want to get hollow cheeks. So we have youth, we have beauty, and we have fertility. Why fertility? It signals high cheeks in a hollow here, signals good hormones, meaning high estrogen, good fertility, and that in turn is what our psyche says is attractive. Youth, beauty, and fertility. So the hollow here is thus very important. Now there's a key here, because the hollow, as you know, can also be aging. Why? Oftentimes you see someone with a round face as they're younger, and they get a chiseled face as they get older naturally. It's, thank goodness for many of us, the cheapest way that we just develop hollow cheeks. But when is it actually really aging? When you have the hollow here, but then you have other hollows such as smile lines or hollows beneath the eyes or a preauricular hollow, right auricle preauricular in front of the ear. If that's too hollow and you have the buccal hollow here, that says age. And those hollows together say age. But the face hollow itself, many people desire to get it. Look at Tom Brady. Recently, he was critiqued for having too much Botox. But if you look at his earlier pictures, he had a more round face. And as he aged, his face became more chiseled. I think a lot of that's natural. But someone in his position as well, they're going to do what we call tweakments, little things along the way that are almost imperceptible. But you can see, as a male, a lot of women, you tell me, find him attractive. And he certainly has that hollow cheek look. And not a lot of other hollows that say age. So very well done. Studies have also shown us that this is attractive. In fact, when 20,000 people were shown pictures, they picked the people with hollow cheeks, with high cheekbones, is more attractive. So how are we going to get these? Well, let's start with the two M's. Number one is makeup. You know way more about that. I'm not going to talk about it, but you know everyone's contouring the cheeks. I even see watch males, male comedians even, when they're on stage and they have their makeup done, they have high cheeks contoured in and a hollow in the buccal area. So makeup is easy. Number two is mewing. Now, I want to hear from you below in the comments. Have you tried it? Mewing is very common. The part of the problem with mewing is people have a hard time keeping up with it. They'll often do it for 7 to 10 days, and then they just stop. Now, what is mewing? I know you're going to ask. Many of you know it, but it's about trying to change your jaw shape by the position of the tongue on the roof of the mouth. The positives are that people believe that you can change the jaw shape. There's no scientific proof, although the inventors, I think, would say there is. There's no good study that I've seen. Certainly, you can send me one. The negatives could be you could get TMJ or temporomandibular joint pain. How do you do it? Roughly, I'm no pro. They have to do it for 3 to 6 months to see some changes. So a lot of people drop out early, as I say. But what you do is you close the mouth. Your bottom teeth are just behind your top teeth. And you put the tongue to the roof of the mouth with your tip of the tongue is going to be just behind your teeth. So if you were to say mewing, when you say the NG part, that's where your tongue sits. So videoing, looking younger and you want to be youthful, you would do mewing. And where that with the NG sound, where that tip of your tongue sits is kind of the position that it should be. Now, I know many of you might like to do this because it's free. You can do it in your spare time, do it many times a day. And people learn to go to sleep like this because it's supposed to also help with sleep apnea. If you're doing it, I definitely want to know in the comments below, are you seeing results? More importantly, are you able to maintain it for 3 to 6 months to start to see those results? One of the key things that I see all online, the people who are doing it are proponents. They're getting a lot of YouTube views, Instagram, TikTok views, but the thing is, they're starting off with an amazing jawline to begin with. A third way that some people get it is by increasing the masseter. So we're going to talk about the cheekbone in a minute, but by increasing the masseter, the muscle right here, people have chewing devices, people chew gum. A lot of us are clenchers. One dentist, a patient of mine said, we all clench, we just don't know it. But clenching causes an increased masseter, so if you have increased size here, by nature you'll have a hollow here for most people. The more you build it up, the more hollow here. The next way that's accessible to many people, and many of you are already doing it, RF microneedling. Now, RF microneedling is microneedles that go into the face that heat. And these needles can then get rid of fat. And it's a pretty good way. I do 2 to 3 of these a day in my clinic. It's a pretty good way to remove fat from different areas, but particularly if you want to remove fat below the cheek, submentum, of course, and along the jawline. But for a lot of people, younger people come in simply to contour a hollow cheek look. Typically takes 2 to 3 sessions, and I have a video on face slimming that you might want to watch, and it shows me do that procedure. Look here, Rebel Wilson. After an 80-pound weight loss, she says, I feel much more confident. I've always felt confident, but I'm much more confident now. Look at the facial change after weight loss. This is a very inexpensive thing that you can do at home. Look at the jawline, a little more cheek contour there, and you can see a few more pounds, and she would definitely have a cheek hollow, but it takes her more towards attractive. So losing weight is certainly one method that a lot of people can do, have done, and transform their face. Another option, this is very common, I do this overseas. It's not commonly done in the Western world, in America and Canada, particularly because of the side effects, and that is injections of fat dissolving product, PCDC, or phosphatidylcholine deoxycholate. You might know deoxycholate, part of that combination, as Kybella in the US, or Belkira is the same product in Canada. The same people who make Botox make it. But there's hundreds of variations of these around the world and even in the United States and Canada. You can inject these microdosing to remove fat. Now, I don't recommend most people do this. It can affect the nerve. The nerve always comes back. But in other countries, people are much more apt to be like, hey, if I have a crooked smile, if I don't look right for a while, but it comes back in 6 weeks and end up with a permanent hollow cheek, I'm happy. But in many countries, that's not accepted. It does take a few sessions, so the risk versus reward, you have to calculate. But I've certainly done it. I like the result. It's something to look into. Now, here's an easy one and very accessible to so many people, cheek filler. Just by injecting the cheek with filler, you build up the zygomatic bone. And imagine if you at the same time built up the masseter, that's a double whammy, but just by simply getting cheek filler, you get the cheek hollow below it. Very easy to do. Think about 1 vial per side. You can go temporary hyaluronic acid fillers. You can go biostimulator, Sculptor, or plasma fill. I even like permanent here, something called Bellafill. I have videos on all of those. Just go into Google or into your YouTube search, put in Rajani Bellafill. Rajani cheeks, Rajani filler cheeks, they'll all come up. I have one great video you want to watch, Hollywood cheeks. That's a nice one, shows how to create that hollow. But that's available to most people, anywhere from $500. Permanent would be up to around $3,000. And permanent's great for that area, same with the temple. You can create a nice hollow cheek, high cheek bone on the zygoma, and then fill in the temple a little bit, and that can last you forever. and it looks amazing, creates that look. Now, if you want permanent and you're into surgery, buccal fat removal, you'll know the buccal fat removal trend was on, and that's where you go in the mouth, you remove the fat. I have a whole video on that. There's a nerve there, a facial nerve. You got to be very careful. And when you take that out, it can be dramatic. You can see here a picture of Leah Michelle, rumored earlier this year to have had buccal fat removal. Check this out. It's quite dramatic. And in my opinion, if you look at it, it's quite aging. Certainly makeup plays a role here, but you get an idea of a surgical type of result. But what a lot of people find is when they look at before and afters of people who've had it done, they say, hey, the person looked way too old. You take a 25-year-old who had it, they might then look 35 or 40, which is too old in the acting actress world or in Hollywood, or to be a supermodel to start off. So it can really change someone's appearance, especially as they start to age. You can reverse it in the sense we add plasma sculpt below it. Works very nice. It's a biostimulator and we can feather that in, but that gets expensive. $5,000 to take it out, another $5,000 to $10,000 to reverse it. You're into this, whatever you're at, $12,000-$15,000. So you gotta be sure you want that surgery, but it definitely creates that look. A cool thing for you, if you're into skincare, go over to quizmd.com. If you answer a few questions, you will get your skincare routine for your skin type as I would recommend in my clinic to my patients. So it just takes 5 minutes and you figure out what your skincare routine you should be on to have beautiful, glowing, vibrant skin. I do have a complete video on how you can change your face with weight loss and exactly how much weight it takes to get that look. I'll link that video at the end. You're now gonna wanna watch this video on Hollywood cheeks and one down here on skin thinning, how you can keep your skin thicker and more robust. Stay tuned here, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.